Beautiful waters. So this is Mockler Beach.
I hope she's actually here.
What is it, Lafayette?
I was told that women's looks can be deceiving, but I'm not sure what I'm supposed to see.
That's an age-old problem for men. You with me, Aizen?
Aye. Women are fickle creatures at best. They lie as easily as they breathe, and men can never see through their deceptions.
I totally feel you.
Sounds like you've both been through hard times.
The wounds women leave on a man's heart take longer to heal than a cut delivered by a sword.
It's that bad?
Beware a maiden's tears, boy, and guard yourself well. That's my advice to you.
Beware tears and guard myself.
Don't put any weird ideas into Lafayette's head, you two.
They're just facts.
If you fill his head with any more garbage, I'm eating both of you.
Yes, ma'am. Yikes.
The swordsman and the pirate having troubles with women? Ha! Well, women are nothing if not difficult. I've the deepest sympathy for you both.
What do you think of the ladies' reactions?
Well, Velvet won't eat either of you, and Mogilu didn't seem sympathetic at all.
See? Appearances can be deceiving.
And it seems you've absorbed the lesson well.
Right.
I'm not like that, though.
Huh?
Yes, some women use their tears to manipulate others. But not all do. And I, for one, despise such duplicity. The women who did that to Aizen and Rokuro are just the extreme.
Yeah, I can see how much you hate dishonesty, Eleanor.
Huh? Yeah, that's right.
Be a good example for the boy, then, so he doesn't end up like Rokuro and me.
I intend to do just that, whether or not you ask it of me.
Eleanor is a lot stronger than she appears.
Your style is really unique.
Just wait until I pull out the goods. Thank you.
This grimoire who we're searching for is a Moloch like Bienfu, right? To be honest, I don't see how someone so different can be a Moloch just the same as Lafayette or Aizen.
I understand your doubts. It's quite the tangly mess.
I'll tell you anything!
In that case, I've been wondering, what's underneath your hat?
Oh no! Anything but that!
So, we've hit a wall already.
But that ribbon flaps around and gets in the way, right? Could I take it off for you?
No! No! That's not possible! You mustn't remove the ribbon!
Why not?
That's another thing I can't say!
It's all cans with you. All right, is there anything you can tell me?
I could talk about what type of Malakim we are, or our position in the world of Malakim, or our abilities.
Oh, I'd like to know all that.
Then I will tell you. Listen closely. We Norman are a well-established race of Malakim. Compared to other Malakim, we aren't as adept at manipulating natural forces, but we excel at drawing out and heightening the abilities of others.
Think of them as a convenient power-up.
They're also known as common spirits.
Don't even say that! We Norman hate being called that.
Why is it so painful for you?
Because it makes people think we're average and unremarkable. That's why we work so hard to show how we're all different.
That does explain your quirky speaking mannerisms.
Don't sweat it. That's a perfectly common thing to worry about.
Don't say that!
So what's it really like?
Huh?
The connection between Moloch and Vessel. Do you share, like, thoughts and feelings?
Sort of. When I'm dwelling inside Eleanor, I can see what she sees and hear what she hears. But I can't read her thoughts or her emotions. Sitting in a box doesn't teach you how the box feels.
I see. In that case, I want to give her as little time alone as possible.
I don't want to bathe with her, all right?
I know. You're a boy and all. For her baths, we can send Bienfu. No, that's a bad idea. It'll have to be Mogulu, or myself.
Phew!
What sort of boundaries have you and Eleanor drawn? How do you sleep?
We talk before bed sometimes, but it's not like I'm sleeping by her side or anything. It's easier for me to tell when she wakes up if I'm dwelling inside her.
Does she ever get out of bed at night?
Not in my experience. And she sleeps so peacefully.
Huh?
When she's around you guys, she always looks so stern. But when she's sleeping, her expression is softer, you could say. She lets her hair down, too. And I think it's kind of prettier that way.
Huh. So that's what he likes. Well, keep an eye on her, but...
But?
Watch out for the older girls.
Huh? What are those penguins doing?
Probably keeping their eggs warm.
Most likely. They look like a mama and a papa. Penguins are monogamous, faithful creatures. They never leave their mate. Isn't that romantic?
So they lay eggs because they're like husband and wife. But how do they make the eggs?
That's... well...
So, Luffy said, here's an interesting fact. A single penguin egg actually contains dozens of smaller orange eggs.
Oh, so their eggs must be small and crunchy.
Yep. They have the texture of caviar and the rich flavor of sea urchins.
Interesting. So they're more like fish than birds.
So you've eaten them. How cruel. Look how much they care about their young.
While it may be a bit cruel, they taste amazing. They're considered a delicacy in some circles. Top a bowl of rice with these crunchy eggs and some rich penguin thigh meat, and you get a dish called family fricassee.
That's a horrific name.
I wasn't the one who named it, okay?
Those eggs look tasty, but I think I'll pass.
Ah!
Close one, but I am the victor.
Is that
Grimoire?
She's moving away.
Just a big lizard demon.
Is it friends with Dial?
Steady and glamour!
Huh?
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 You too.
Was a close one, but I am the victor.
Thank you. Thank you.